Good morning, my dear students. We are back with our science period. Do you remember which lesson we have started? Yes, we have started the lesson soil erosion and its conservation. Which lesson we have started? Soil erosion and its conservation. What things are there? What we have learned? You just recall all the points what we have learned in the last video. First video we have discussed about how the soil is formed. What is the importance of soil? What are the uses of soil? Yes or no? Then in the next video we have discussed the different layer of soil. Yes or no? There are the three layers, that is topsoil, subsoil and bedrock. The topsoil is very important. It is very important. Yes or no? Then we have discussed about the soil erosion. If we will remove the topsoil, then what will happen? The soil will not become a fertile. Yes or no? Then what are the removal of the topsoil will causes the soil erosion. It will cause the soil erosion. Then we have discussed how the topsoil is removed. There are some natural things or the natural activities by which the topsoil is removed. For example, by the rain, by the process of raining, then by wind. Yes, the topsoil is removed. How it is removed? If the land is totally bare, then it can easily flow away. Yes or no? So what are the causes? What are the causes of the soil erosion? First is rain, wind. Am I right? And one more factor is responsible for the soil erosion. Yes, the human being is responsible for the soil erosion. How we are responsible? Because of the deforestation. Yes or no? Because of the deforestation, overgrazing and plowing. This already we have discussed in the last video. So now let's learn how to conserve the soil. See, soil is a man-made or natural thing? Can you just tell me? Yes, it is a natural thing which takes a millions of years to form a soil. We have discussed how the soil is formed. Yes or no? So soil, to form a soil, soil is very, very important. As it is a natural resource, it takes a millions of years to form a soil. Yes or no? So it is our duty to conserve the soil. So there are the different ways to conserve the soil. So which are the different ways? See, these are the different ways to conserve the soil. First is afforestation. Now what is meant by the afforestation? We have discussed deforestation. What is meant by the deforestation? Deforestation is nothing but the cutting down of the trees on the large scale. So it is the opposite of afforestation. Afforestation means what? Growing the number of trees on the large scale. So what first drawback what we have learned? Due to the human activity, the first is deforestation. So here is the, we have to do the opposite, that we have to grow the large number of trees. Yes or no? Which will helps to prevent the soil erosion. Are you getting? Then the next is growing the plants in the farmland. Now what is this? See, there are some lands around us which are totally bare. Bare means what? There is nothing. We can't, in some cases or on some land it is impossible to grow the plants. So in that case we can grow the grass, which will helps to prevent the soil erosion, which will helps to prevent the soil erosion. So wherever the land is totally a bare, you can plant their grass. Or you might have heard about some farmers cultivate the crops twice in a year, which will help to protect the soil erosion. Are you getting? It makes the soil fertile. Are you getting? So growing the plants in a farmland where the land is bare, you have to grow the plants instead of land. If the plants are not possible, we can grow the grass. Are you getting? So this is the second method or a second thing, how we can prevent the or how we can conserve the soil. Then next is in the causes or the factors where the human being is responsible. The second we have learned about overgrazing. Yes or no? So what is meant by the overgrazing? Some animals or cow or sheep are taken at the same area for grazing. The animals at the same area. What happens if we are taking at the same area? The animals will eat all the grass till the end of the root. Yes or no? So it will affect for the soil. It will make the soil loose. So avoid the overgrazing. If we have taken the animals for this for the particular area, we have to take the animals next day to the next area, so that it will help that particular land to grow little. Animals should not allow to graze at a same area. We have to change the area. Are you getting? So avoid the overgrazing. Then next is construction of embankments. Now what is this construction of embankments? Now where the rivers are flowing, where there are the rivers, streams, what we have to the strong embankment should be built of rocks and a stone, which will help to prevent the soil from flowing away, which will help the soil to flow, help the soil from flowing away through water or the river. So strong embankments of the rocks and stones should be constructed near the rivers. Then the last point is stiff farming. Now what is meant by the stiff farming? If you might have visited to the hillside, there is a rapid rainfall. Yes or no? So there is a large amount of rainfall. So for that, what happened? The lot of fertile soil, it carries the lot of fertile soil. Are you getting? So in near the hillside, the farming is done by cutting the stape in the hill. So that method is called as a stape farming, or another name for the stape farming is terrace farming. Are you getting? Another name it is for the stape farming is a terrace farming. Because of this method we can reduce the soil, because of this method we can reduce the speed of the water, which will help or which will prevent the soil erosion, this will help to reduce the fertility of the topsoil. Are you getting? So these are the steps to conserve the soil erosion. Are you getting? So these are the steps to conserve the soil. The first, once again we will repeat it. The first is afforestation. What is meant by the afforestation? Growing of the plants on the large scale. That is called as a afforestation. Then the next is growing the plants in the farmland. Now what is meant by the farmland? Where the land is totally bare, you have to at least, means if we can't grow the good quality of the plants, at least we have to try to grow the grasses in that area. Are you getting? So growing the plants in a farmland, then avoid overgrazing. Overgrazing, we have learned what is meant by the overgrazing. Some animals are taken to the graze at the same area for a longer period of time, which help for the soil erosion, which loses the soil, and it can affect for the soil erosion. As the soil will become a loose, it will be carried out by the rainwater or by wind easily. Are you getting? So we should avoid the overgrazing at a same area. We have to take care that the plant animal should be shifted. If we have taken to the particular area, animals for the particular area, next day we have to carry for the next area. Are you getting? So avoid overgrazing. Then construction of embankment. Now where the rivers are flowing continuously, or the streams are flowing continuously, we have to build the strong embankment which will be constructed of stone and the rocks. Then the next is strip farming. It is also called as a terrace farming. Strip farming, it is mostly done in the hillside area where the rainfall is on the large scale, which will affect the soil. So we have to conserve the soil, as the soil is formed by the natural resource which takes a millions of years to form. So we have to take the care of the soil, as it is a very important for us. Are you getting? So today's work is that you have to read the lesson twice, remove the difficult words from the lesson, and write twice in your notebook, and do the practice of the diagram of layer of soil. Are you getting? Thank you.